Hello, I'm FPX Toycat, and as you're probably aware by now, the 1.16 never update is coming out pretty soon. They're in the bug fixing and tweaking phase of the update, so we can expect that all of the features in that update right now are going to be the features in the final update when it releases in the upcoming weeks. However, if you follow Minecraft developers and the Minecraft news cycle, you might be confused as to why certain features that seemed like they were coming in the next update a couple of updates ago have not made their way into this update and why indeed they are missing. And I want to start with the first one here because the first one is perhaps the biggest shame, because when they introduced the smithing table and the fletching table to the game, they said they would be used as a village worksite, but they wouldn't have functionality for the blocks in this update, as they want to make sure they're useful for the overall gameplay, but they have a great idea for them in the next major themed update. We now know the major idea for the smithing table was Neverite. That's been discussed as being an idea that's been around in Minecraft for years. They were planning the smithing table and the Neverite thing together, clearly for quite some time, and therefore in this update, clearly something was planned regarding the fletching table and using four planks and two flint to do something new that wasn't going to be available before the Never update. And this is why it's such a weird thing that even though now 1.16 is pretty much feature complete, now the smithing table has its final use as being a way to upgrade tools and make them Neverite, the fletching table is still entirely unusable in the latest snapshot and indeed the latest beta. So there's an endless number of things this could be, and I love the idea of speculating about it all day, but real quickly, I think there are two main things they could have been intending for right here. The first is that the smithing and the fletching table, they came together, and clearly they were intended to do something together. Maybe the fletching table was going to allow you to add Neverite to certain ranged equipment things. Maybe they were planning to make Neverite bows or a Neverite crossbow for this update. I mean, it makes sense if it was a crossbow given it came in the Village and Pillage update, but they didn't have a way to improve the tier on that yet. Maybe they were intending to add more ranged weaponry, although given that a fletching table usually focuses on arrows, it could be more likely that instead they were going to make Neverite arrows as the tier up from regular arrows, because right now we have arrows, we have a bunch of potion arrows on Java. There are spectral arrows and that's about it. Having a actual slightly more damaging arrow that costs a lot more to craft, you know, a single stack of arrows would take a whole Neverite ingot, that would be a cool way to improve your ranged game for those specific targets that are worth it. For killing the Wither, for killing the Dragon, and for PvP, those three things could justify the Neverite arrows, and that could be pretty darn cool. Maybe they decide at the end though that Neverite is too hard to obtain. I mean, right now you have to mine for an absurd amount of time and nobody would be willing to do that just to make a single stack of Neverite arrows. Perhaps could be seen as the thing. But yeah, there was clearly some intention with the Never update and with a fletching table that never came to fruition, which is super sad. But the sadder thing is not the fletching table, which, let's be honest, people forget about it when they're not doing things for villagers. But the thing people hadn't forgotten about is the fact that at Minecon 2019 or Minecon Earth 2019 or Minecon Live, the big event where you see the big Minecraft progress in the last year, it's a pretty interesting event, right? Lots of people watch it and lots of people vote on what they want to be the next biome Minecraft updates. And obviously you might think that's me being like, oh, they didn't say it'd be the next biome. No, here is the description from the YouTube video. Biome vote announcement trailer on September 28. We want you to help us decide which biome will update next in Minecraft. During Minecon Live, voting will open to choose which of the three new biomes gets features and a new mob. They specifically said this is for the biome they'll update next. And although, you could maybe argue that 1.15 was a small update and so they couldn't get that done in time, the fact that 1.16 doesn't have these new biome features is a huge omission, given that already if they put it in 1.16, it would have been 9 months between when the people of Minecraft voted for it and when it came to the game. And so as a result, there are three features which Minecraft users voted for, Minecraft developers said they would add to the game, pretty much promised, right? And those three features are the brand new mountain generation. So to quote Jeb on this, the lead designer for Minecraft, jagged cliffs, snow-capped peaks, and climactic views were all going to be things added to the mountain generation. They were going to change mountains and the extreme hill biome from being this kind of big hill to being actual mountains that could really change your landscape and actually look pretty darn impressive. So that obviously is something we haven't seen in 1.16. Goats were promised as a brand new mob because it's not just a biome update, it's a brand new mob as well. The goats are obviously going to be in the extreme hills. Where are the goats? We don't know about those. And then finally, there's snowier snow. The snow is snowier than before, as Lady Agnes puts it. And although there have been rumors and words about this potentially just being the way that Bedrock Snow works right now, where it could obviously stack into a lot of different blocks and in different ways, the word is that that could just be coming to Java. The fact is, the new mountain generation and the goats, at the very least, were assumed to be in the next big update. And when they weren't in 1.15, it was already kind of weird, but now 1.16 is here, and the features people voted on are not coming to the game. So the interesting answer of when they actually are coming is something we don't really know for sure, but what we do know is that mountains really do kind of need an update. I mean, in 1.14, they, alongside updating the villages, they updated the tiger a little bit. In 1.13, alongside updating the oceans. They added in the Phantom, a kind of sleep mechanic. I feel like adding a secondary theme to every update, a secondary mini set of features, is always an important thing to do because, again, although the Never is something I love, it's something a lot of people are going to enjoy, and you'll be able to tell, you know, from the big increase in people playing Minecraft over the next month or so, that people are going to enjoy the new Never. However, a mono-focused update, because, you know, there are smaller things around the edge of it, but a mono-focused update without kind of a secondary batch of features is kind of missing something, right? I mean, ignoring the fact that there's like 5%, maybe a little more, maybe a little less, of players who are never going to use the Never regardless, who won't be able to appreciate those features, and people who are just playing Minecraft to get to the Never, when they look around the overworld and don't see any changes, it's going to be a little bit of a shame. I feel like having new mountains, just a slight increase to their generation, would be really cool. Because for the Village and Pillage update, it was actually part of the Cats and Pandas update for Bedrock, but for that update, when they were subtly updating jungles, all they did was add a sub-biome to the jungle type, so they didn't break seeds, your existing jungles would work fine, but also, if you found a new jungle, there was a small chance that it would contain a jungle with the panda bears, and indeed the bamboo. That was a cool way to add a new feature to encourage you to explore more of your world, look for something you already knew existed, and without having any breaks in it. And I feel like that's what you could do with mountains. Keep the existing mountain generation, add in the new type with the jagged cliffs, the snow-capped peaks, and the climactic views, you know, totally makes sense. And then you'd give people more reasons to explore the overworld as well as the Never. Maybe it's just because, you know, the Never update, they don't want to be focusing too much on the overworld, but it still feels very weird that 1.16 is not including the features we voted on 9 months ago. So when is this coming to the game? There is only one quote here, because someone asked Maria Lemon, one of the Minecraft developers at the time, that there seems to be some confusion going around since it wasn't entirely clear in the stream, will the Never and Mountain biome be updated in Java 1.15 or 1.16 or even a later update? And then she responds 1.16, but mountains will come in a later update. This is the only acknowledgement we got from a Minecraft developer about the mountain features at all after the vote. And here's the even more confusing thing. Maria Lemon has actually left Mojang. So this is, you know, although like she was working there at the time, there is no developer that currently works at Mojang that has actually said anything regarding the mountain features. Is 1.17 just going to be an entire mountain update and that's the reason why? It's possible. I mean, they are doing a smaller update at the end of each year. As we know, there's two updates in each Minecraft year now. There is the big update in the beginning, then there's the small update at the end. Maybe the entire update they're doing for the second half this year will be the mountains, and that's the flow they're going for. I mean, it's possible. It might make some sense, but without saying it, without even making the slightest of reference to the fact that, yeah, actually, we're definitely going to, you know, add mountains. Right now, it's just like, oh yeah, you voted on a feature. We said all of the features in that video would come, the swamp, you know, the boat chests and the frogs and everything else that people want from that at some point, and apparently the things we vote for also comes at some point. It just feels super weird in my opinion that there's all these features that are confirmed becoming at some point, and apparently just voting on them just made them go from some point in the next 5 to 10 to 20 years or whatever to some point in the next few years, probably, if we get around to it. When there is this vote where you directly ask the community what they want in the game, you make people vote saying, hey, we want your feedback for the game, it's important to actually listen to that feedback or at least talk about what's going on, because a lot of people feel like, oh yeah, we voted for these features and then they gave up on it. Because if you don't hear about something in long enough, you either forget about it, which I'd say like a decent majority of people have done by now, or you just assume that it's not happening whatsoever, because again, nothing has been said, nothing has been heard, and that is a real shame. So to recap, in 1.17, something you can likely expect is the fletching table revamp that they planned. Something you can likely expect is the mountain generation to change to have those jagged cliffs, those snow-capped peaks, those climactic views. You can probably expect goats, and you can probably expect snowier snow, because those were all things expected in the next big Minecraft update, and the next big Minecraft update sadly has not delivered on any of them. But it does have to be mentioned, 1.16 still has a huge number of features. I mean, this is one of the biggest major updates we've had in a while. I guess taking on the Never just meant they had to put a lot of things on the sidelines, and that's the reason for all of these things. Because if you look at 1.16 and what's actually inside of it, fun fact, I made a video showing off all 109 features. We have the most new blocks for any Minecraft update. We have an overhaul, not just adding a new tier of weapons and stuff, but also they've added, you know, they fixed the hoes, they've made them better and made them an actual tool in Minecraft. They've added a new tool, a new tier of weapon and tool. They've added a new type of armor. They've added new enchantments. They've added a new trading system. And honestly, this is one of the big updates in terms of what's going on. Maybe the intention of this update is to stop doing what they've done before, where they kind of have too many, you know, major sub themes that it's hard to categorize the entire update. I mean, the Frostburn update being 1.10. What do you remember from 1.10? Be honest with me, but tell me all the features you remember from that update, like maybe polar bears or something, and also some features for the Nether, but it wasn't even very many. Like the red Nether brick and the Nether wall blocks were nice, but how often do you use them? You know, like that update was too non-focused, and indeed, you know, until like I'd say the update Aquatic, the Minecraft focus was really lost from update to update, and now they're trying extra hard to go all the way in on one feature, and I guess the 1.16 Nether update is the way we'll find out for sure if people prefer that or if people liked a bit more the 1.12 or perhaps the 1.14 idea where there's a key focus on the update, you know, colored blocks and of course villages respectively, but then on the outside of that there's a lot of other features on there. That's something we're gonna have to find out when 1.16 does come out. If you're curious about when that is, obviously no one can give you a precise date because no precise date has been given by Mojang. We can make one up out of thin air and say, you know what it's gonna be, it's definitely gonna be May the 26th, but we don't know for sure until that happens. Although put May 26th in your calendar and let's see if I'm right when that does come out, and if so I'll say, oh yeah, I knew the whole time. But you know what I didn't know the whole time? Whether you would enjoy this video, and if you did, I really hope that you consider liking it. Or if you really like this video and you like the new style things on the channel that it's been a while since we've done, but if you like this video a lot you can subscribe and you'll see more of these videos down your homepage. Make sure to hit that bell of course, because that's what real subscribing is on YouTube. Subscribing and perhaps hitting that bell as well is the way of telling YouTube that you want to be in control of what you watch and deciding what comes to you on your homepage and indeed your subscription feed. Thank you if you do decide to do that. If you don't, then I'm excited for these four features. I would predict that the 1.17 update will be a smaller update that will include the mountain update, maybe even be focused on it. And the fletching table is one that I would personally predict is coming sometime further out there, because they did say their plan was for 1.16. So maybe if that plan is gone, it'll be a while till they find a use for it in the future. But I want to hear your theory about what the fletching table will be. Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll heart some theories that I particularly like. So if you want to go read some fletching table theories, that's what the comment section is for. Well, I mean, it's for that, but you're going to see a bunch of comments saying first, and then a bunch of comments like with unrelated memes. And then you're going to see those channels that pretend like they really enjoyed the video, and then they're doing a giveaway on their own. You should never click those, by the way. Those are always scams, and I remove those as fast as I can. But you know, the actual thing the comments are useful for, the people who watch the videos all the way through, they'll be leaving me their fletching table theories. Or at least put the word fletching table somewhere in your comment and I'll know you actually watched this video. So thank you for that, and I'll see you all next time, which is the 109 feature video. If you haven't watched that already, you really need to if you want to know what's in the Nether update. Okay, that's my plug over. Goodbye.